Closer.
Huh?
All right, and we apologize for the technical difficulties this morning, but we are live from the corner of School and North Street for the 2023 Homecoming Parade. This year's theme, Redbirds Rain. The rain has held off, and we've got a good crowd on hand.
All right, and we apologize for the technical difficulties this morning, but we are live from the corner of School and North Street for the 2023 Homecoming Parade.
President,
this year's theme, Redbirds Rain. The rain has held off.
Trustees, and we've got a good crowd on hand.
All right, and we apologize for the technical difficulties.
Coming down the road now, coming up School Street, is the Gamma Phi Circus.
2023 Homecoming
Illinois State University. Circus and
trustees got a good crowd.
Right, Park, 1929. Coming down the road now, coming up School Street, is the Gamma Phi Circus. Illinois State University's Circus and
trustees got a good crowd.
Right, Park, 1929. Coming down the road now, coming up School Street, is the Gamma Phi Circus. Illinois State University's Circus and
Hell's Rocks the World. Got a good crowd.
Coming down the road now. School Street. Gamma Phi Circus. Illinois State University's Circus and
Hell's Rocks the World. Performing in
front of four times. Coming down the road now. School Street. Gamma Phi Circus. Illinois State University's
Circus
parade was originally called the Hobo Parade way back when it started. Continuing to watch the Gamma Phi Circus put on a performance, each of the different acts. You have a front row seat for the Gamma Phi Circus, their show, their home show at Seth Q Arena, of course, happens each April. We're looking forward to that. Earlier today, the annual Town and Gown 5K one-mile walk this morning stepped off at 8 a.m. There were over 300 participants this year in person and also virtually. The runners went down this very route. Gamma Phi continues to perform here for us. Very impressive. Many of those runners stuck around with their families to watch the parade this morning. From the Gamma Phi Circus, and it wouldn't be complete without the clowns and a clown car, no less. Students from all different majors, all different years in school, make this circus possible. And we thank them for a truly unique experience here at Illinois State. And following the Gamify Circus is the Illinois State Alumni Board, the Illinois State University Alumni Association Board of Directors, the ambassadors, advocates, and advisors serving to strengthen the university's traditions, its future growth, and its networks of influence. And here's the Black Colleagues Association celebrating 40 years next year. Illinois State's Black Colleagues Association is a diverse and dynamic group of alumni and friends of Illinois State University, comprised of alumni who attended the university from the 1940s through the most recent graduating class. More than 7,000 African Americans have attended or graduated from Illinois State and are potential ISUBCA members. Black Colleagues Associate Network can help you remain connected to your alma mater through a variety of events. Here's Mayor Chris Coos from the town of Normal. Mayor Coos has been the mayor since 2003. And here we have the Percy Hall of Fame inductee, starting with Ginny Cabas Fuente. Ginny Cabas was a volleyball player from 1998 to 2002, a two-time MVC first team selection and four-time All-MVC pick. She's followed by Cameron Siskowick, Stacy Miller, women's golf, and Dennis Banks, the Campbell Stretch Miller Award winner, the longtime photographer for Illinois State University Athletics. So again, the Hall of Famers, Mike Jones, wrestling, Ginny Cabas Fuente, volleyball, Stacy Miller, golf, and Cameron Siskowick, football, and Dennis Banks, university photographer. All of those folks were honored earlier this morning at a breakfast at the Bone Student Center. Continuing with Illinois State Athletics, the women's gymnastics team, the 2023 Midwest Independent Conference champions, Elena Laster and Jay Mack, were each selected to compete in the 2023 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Regional hosted by Oklahoma. Their season starts up in January. Redbird student athletes. Making the walk, and a reminder, the women's volleyball team, winners last night, they play again tonight at 7 o'clock at CEFQ Arena. And if you have a football ticket to the Illinois State versus Indiana State football game this afternoon, you can redeem that for free admission to the volleyball match this evening. Little Jewels next in the parade, passing us here at our stop. Each year they bring a special group out to support ISU homecoming. Thomas Metcalf School. Part of the College of Education here at Illinois State University. Metcalf Laboratory School, a caring community of lifelong learners. Its mission is to act as a model for educational methods and theory in support of the preparation of future educators, conduct educational research, offer quality educational programs for children, and disseminate information to others in the education profession. Third place finish in the RSO parade, and that was the Student Alumni Council that just passed by. Heartland Head Start making an appearance this year. And Kingsley Junior High Cougars. Kingsley Junior High, right across from CEFQ Arena, almost right on campus here at Illinois State. We have some representatives from the Holiday Spectacular. The annual Holiday Spectacular, Central Illinois Holiday Tradition, December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd at Bloomington Center for the Performing Arts. I'm sure you can hear in the microphone that wind has really picked up from the north as it's feeling more and more like fall. Beautiful fall colors on the quad. Oh, and here we have the winner for the community float, the Holiday Spectacular. Congratulations for winning best community float. Looking forward to seeing the Holiday Spectacular performances. We have ISU competitive dance, a competitive collegiate dance team that represents the university at national collegiate level competition, the official sport club dance team at the university. Again, we thank you for joining us for Homecoming 2023. Plain County Dance Association. Teaching and performing dance as an art form since 1976. Plain County Dance Association offers classes in ballet, point modern, jazz, tap, lyric, hip-hop, and musical theater. Chuck Erickson running for McLean County Board in the parade today. Looks like we have some colleges coming up here and some, as well as some departments. This is the, I believe, the Construction Management Student Association. School of Communication. Oh, that's Safety Professionals that just passed by, but Construction Management Student Association is coming up. And you see a 2011 Ford Mustang GT. This is driven by senior construction management major Dominic Post. There's an online story about that. Also his sister, you see there, Danielle Post. They both race that dragster, that 2011 Mustang. You can hear it. Surely the loudest vehicle in the parade. They top out around 150 miles per hour in that. Dominic is a senior construction management major, and Danielle is a sophomore bilingual elementary education major, who also, she could have been marching with her sorority, Alpha Omicron Pi. College Democrats making an appearance today. If you want to read more about that 2011 Ford Mustang and the two Illinois State seniors who drive it, check out news.illinoisstate.edu. There's a great story there about two students with a sort of unique hobby that they do on the weekends and have a lot of success with. Student Counseling Services makes the turn onto North Street. Followed by the Celtic Cross Pipes and Drums. Celtic Cross Pipes and Drums live life with Highland Music, celebrating 7 years as Midwest Pipe Band Association's Champion Supreme, the Celtic Cross. Another dance team, the Poise Dance Team. Still hear that Mustang roaring down North Street. Poise Dance Team, a dance RSO at Illinois State, dedicating itself to giving dancers of all backgrounds the opportunity to showcase their art. Anytime Fitness making the turn. Handing out some candy here. They're followed by the Normal Community West High School cheerleaders. Sigma Gamma Rho is the next in the parade. Sigma Gamma Rho, dedicated to enhancing the quality of life for women and their families in the U.S. and globally through community service, civil, and social action. Their goal is to achieve greater progress in the areas of education, health awareness, and leadership development. Their members, affiliates, staff, and community partners work to create and support initiatives that align with their vision. Next up, we have the Olympia Marching Spartans from Olympia High School. We'll listen to them as they pass by our location. Spartans, one of over 100 units in the parade today, making this the largest parade in the town of Normal annually. And as we watch the parade head into Uptown Normal, don't forget to visit Uptown at night throughout the holiday season to take in the popular and whimsical red and white lights that were turned on this past Monday to kick off homecoming week. At the annual tree lighting ceremony, we have the Graduate Workers Union. They were formed in 2018. The graduate students at ISU with teaching assistantships voted to form a union and won legal recognition. They're a group of TAs who come together with co-workers to collectively advocate for and negotiate with employers on behalf of the entire group. And they're followed by the ISU EA, Illinois State University Education Association. Reminder, as you see the Jeep decked out with footballs, the Redbird football team plays at 2 this afternoon against Indiana State at Hancock Stadium. The volleyball team plays later this evening at 7 o'clock at CEFQ Arena. Music connections with a ton of folks behind the parade here today, behind their float. And the candy just keeps on flowing. This will get the kids by until Halloween, I'd say. Next, we have the Mennonite College of Nursing. Exciting year for Mennonite College of Nursing. They broke ground on a major expansion of their simulation center here at Illinois State and also opened a brand new program down in Springfield as they tried to grow their enrollment to try to meet the nationwide nursing shortage by producing high-quality nurses from here at Illinois State University. And we thank the nurses both the students and the alumni for their service. Party bus. A plus party bus. Probably see some of those out and about later this evening as students celebrate homecoming. We have another award-winning float coming your way. This is the Bloomington Normal Warriors Lacrosse. This float won third place for best community float. Bloomington Normal Lacrosse is to foster the development of their members by teaching the values of responsibility, respect, sportsmanship, and teamwork. And they're trying to continue to develop what they say is one of the fastest growing sports in Bloomington Normal. The School of Kinesiology and Recreation, Physical Education, Teacher Education. American Legion. American Legion was established in 1919 by World War I veterans to assist disabled veterans and their families. The American Legion is the nation's largest veterans service organization. Locally based right down the road here in Uptown Normal. After the parade, I'm sure a number of folks will be headed over to tailgating, and new this year is Redbird Village, formerly the Redbird Tent Dome. It'll take place in Horton Fieldhouse. Considering the weather, that's probably a good thing this year, as all colleges will be represented as attendees can grab tailgate food, favorites, also listen to WZND Radio, check out Reggie's Kid Zone and ISU merch, and more. Moms Demand Action, the next group passing by. And here, I believe, is the construction management float. Which won second place for best registered student organization float. So here it is, second place, construction management. Construction Management Student Association is an organization that promotes and encourages its members' extracurricular professional development through leadership opportunities, workshops, seminars, conferences, and cooperative activities with the construction community. Evans Junior High School making an appearance, another one of the Unit 5 middle schools. Next is the Studio Project, another award-winning dance program here in town. Lots of opportunities for young dancers. They're a drop-in facility with no registration fee and no monthly commitments. They're appearing in the parade here today. Thanks again for tuning in and joining us remotely for the 2023 Illinois State Homecoming Parade. I'm John Twerk from University Marketing and Communications. So happy to have you along with us. The weather could be much worse. Earlier this week, they were predicting sort of driving rain at this time. Unfortunately, the rain has held off, but it has gotten much windier. But the weather couldn't keep a lot of folks away who are lining the parade route this afternoon, or this morning. In case you missed them earlier, the Illinois State alumni marshals this year were Dan Kelly and Melinda Fisher. And here we have another award-winning float. This is first place for RSOs. It is the Spanish Club. There's the best RSO float of the year. The Spanish Club is Illinois State. At Illinois State encourages students and members of the club to improve their knowledge in Spanish as a second language and also to expose them to the Hispanic culture. Congratulations on winning best float, the ISU Spanish Club. Lily Strode, the Elks National Americanism Essay winner. Next we have another Illinois State RSO. This is the Independent Service Dog Association. Independent Service Dogs is a registered student organization. Students from the program are chosen by Paws Giving Independence, a service dog training organization in Peoria, to foster and train service dogs for service work. Students participate as student trainers or foster homes for service dogs, and each student trainer is assigned a dog or dogs to work with. During the time with the dog, the trainer goes through a normal routine of attending classes and running errands while also teaching skills to the dog. Following them is the U-High dance team. And close behind them is 103.3 WZND Fused Radio, the student radio station of Illinois State University. National award-winning collegiate station staffed by students, airing news, music, and sports each day. The Agriculture Education Club, Alpha Tau Alpha. And then I believe this is the Redbird hockey team. The ISU ice hockey team. Founded in 1969, ISU's oldest student-run organization on campus. And last year, the Redbirds advanced to the ACHA Nationals for the first time club history. They are very competitive. They have three different levels of competition. And they play here in town at Grossinger Motors Arena. So we saw the U-High dance team. Here are the U-High cheerleaders. University High School, of course, connected to the College of Education here at Illinois State University. Criminal Justice Sciences with some students walking here today. floats continue to roll by here, School and North Street. This year's theme, Redbirds Reign. So we have another dance group. Here's the School of Social Work. The Social Work Club also being represented. They provide social, educational, and philanthropic extracurricular opportunities for students who are social work majors or who are interested in social work at Illinois State University. Elena Johnson, the queen of the McLean County Fair, making an appearance this morning. WJBC Radio, Cumulus Media. I believe that's Scott Miller driving the vehicle. WJBC, of course, where you can hear Illinois State Redbird Athletics events, including this afternoon's football game against Indiana State, 2 o'clock kickoff time. Those candy buckets have to be filling up at this point. WGLT Radio making an appearance in this year's parade. We're just steps away from their studio here on Illinois State's campus. An NPR member station offering local news and music programs as well. WGLT serving Central Illinois with an audience approaching 25,000 listeners a week and listeners all over the world at WGLT.org. McLean County Republicans follow WGLT. Fancy Audi making the turn here. Representing Auto House. If you haven't already, check out ISU Homecoming on Instagram, a way to stay up to date this weekend and all year long. About Illinois State University Homecoming. Here's Illinois State competitive cheerleading. ISU Competitive Cheer is a club cheerleading team made up of 20 to 30 athletes at Illinois State. They practice twice a week in Horton Fieldhouse, focusing the season on getting ready for the biggest competition of the year, which is the NCAA National Championship in Daytona, Florida, in early April. They compete in the intermediate small co-ed division at that competition. Unlimited dance team follows them. Unlimited dance team, a non-competitive jazz, hip-hop, and contemporary bass team. They're a diverse group who have a common love for dance, and they pride themselves in being friendly and inclusive, a place where dancers can make lifetime friendships. Certainly more dance groups than any other group in this parade, I'd have to say. Iron Coyote following that up, popular among local kids, offers a 20,000 square foot facility, ropes course, trampolines, and obstacle courses. It'd be a good place to warm up after standing out here during the parade for all these youngsters. Twin Cities School of Dance, presenting the Nutcracker. We saw the Holiday Spectacular earlier. Reminds us how close we are getting to the holiday season. It's been a great year here at Illinois State. Near record enrollment, largest incoming class in 36 years. So total enrollments at 20,989, 1.5% increase in total enrollment. Also, a strong fundraising year last year, $34 million in private support. The second time in Illinois State history that the school's raised more than $30 million without an eight-figure gift. So the Redbirds really do reign. They're showing that here today. So we have the Bloomington Cardinals. Some young football players and cheerleaders. And another float making the turn here onto North Street. I was going to say, that's not Reggie Redbird. I believe that's the Cardinal. Maybe a distant relative of Reggie right there. Sort of looks like what maybe Reggie looked like a few decades ago. That's another place to check out, news.illinoisstate.edu. Read about Reggie Redbird, 100 years of Reggie and how he's evolved through those years. He hasn't always looked the way he does today. Next Step Dance Studio. Here toward the tail end of the parade. A reminder, if you weren't able to make it to the parade this morning, thank you for watching, and hopefully we'll see you over at tailgating and then the Redbird football game at 2 o'clock against Indiana State. Redbird volleyball at 7 o'clock this evening against Murray State. The Redbird volleyball team, by the way, on a hot streak as the Redbirds entered the weekend on a four-match winning streak, and they won last night, so it's been five in a row for Redbird volleyball, trying to make it six in a row here this evening. They play again on Monday, and it's Reggie's Kids Club night, so if you're a Reggie's Kids Club member, it's free admission. Just a few more to go here for the homecoming parade, and there's the ISU Annuitants Association, followed by the solar car team. Children's Discovery Museum and Uptown Normal rounds out today's homecoming parade. And so here we go with the police marking the end. Don't see Officer Sage, Illinois State's favorite canine support dog. But that wraps up homecoming parade 2023. Again, we hope to see you at tailgating, at the football game at 2, at the volleyball match at 7. Follow ISU Homecoming on Instagram to stay up to date about all of the fun activities. So thanks again for joining us this morning. That concludes our coverage of the 2023 Illinois State University Homecoming Parade. On behalf of our entire university marketing and communications production team, I'm John Twork saying thanks for watching and happy homecoming 2023.